In this tutorial, I am going to start describing the PHP security. In PHP, the bad people or the hacker can try to hack your code in many ways. So there are some basic things that you should keep on your mind when you will work with the project. I am going to show you some of those. Actually, there are a lot of things because a security is a completely a big thing, a big study. If you want to become a security expert, you will have to study a lot and a long hours and a some couple of months or even years you need to study about this. So it is actually very hard to tell everything, to show every deep and detail about the security. But the major things that you must have to include on your project, I will show some of them. The first thing that when you will go to work with the PHP project, you will have to keep on your mind that the folder content protection, this is a very basic thing. A lot of programmers or a lot of PHP developers do not focus on this, but this is a very important thing. For example, I am going to make a project. This is actually the index file, for example. Now here I create some folders. For example, I create uploads folder or images folder. There I create another folder that is, for example, students. Like this. So in the uploads folder, for example, I put some images. I am going to put some images from other places. That can be flower images, for example, this one, and this one. I am now going to bring those images into the uploads folder. And in the students folder, for example, there are some things, for example, login information, login.php file, or here are, for example, other files, that is logout.php. There are other files, for example, blog.php. This type of files are here, for example, and this is my index.php. Now actually what happens when I am going to the in students and I am going to uploads, a person who want to get your website's folder structure, he can try seeing all the file list. A hacker can try to get the file list, what is into your folder. So what he can do, he can simply open this browser, and here you see that index.php file. But in the index.php file, for example, this is home page. So it is showing on your browser. This is okay, but into the folder, if he try to get something as a prediction, he can start to guess what can be your image folder. Just he put here uploads, images, it's that he can try with. But when he give here uploads, the folder name, he is able to see all the things in this directory. You see that there is on.jpg, 3.jpg. So he can easily see all the photos of this folder from here. Even similarly, if he go to the students folder, he will see all the list of the PHP files here. That is blog.php, login.php, etc. So in order to protect that, you must should protect this thing. So there are two ways we normally applies. That is, into the uploads folder, we create an empty file. That is empty index.php file. You do not need to give anything here. Just keep it is empty. Same file I am going to copy, and into all my folders I am going to paste that. So what will happen? Now, if that person want to see all the things into the students folder, if you try to hit it, he will see nothing here. He will see a completely empty thing. So it is not possible for him to see all the file list. Similarly, the uploads folder, if he hit, he will see a blank page. Because PHP by default, when you go, when you try to enter into a folder, then it by default search for the index.php or index.html, this type of files. So I put a blank file here, that is index. You must have to give here index. Okay, you can also put index.html file here, but index.php I recommend you to use here. So this is one way to give the security of a particular folder. There is another way to do the same thing. For example, in the students folder, I am going to remove it. Now if I go to the students folder, you see all the things. Now what I will do here, I give you another thing, that is you can create a .htaccess file. So in the students folder, I am going to create a new file, that is .htaccess. So in the .htaccess file, if I keep it blank, what will happen? If now a person try to access this, nothing is showing, right? Here I can now use options indexes. This can be the content of this file. So what will happen now, if a person tried to see this file, it will tell him that the server encountered an internal error or misconfiguration and was unable to complete your request. So it will give the person an error message. So you can easily put that, and this thing will be shown. If you give only indexes, it will show you the same thing. So I recommend to use options then hyphen indexes. So in this way you can also protect a folder. So this is the second thing. Another thing, in order to use, for example, some information in your website can be very sensitive and you want to put some user information, username, password, etc. in that file. So what we can do, we sometimes just, for example, going, for example, students into this folder, I want to create a JSON file, data.json. So here the JSON file, here we sometimes try to put something like this. I am going to copy that from here, paste it here. So this is a JSON file. I am going to put it into a good format like this. So for example, you put the username and password into this file. But remember that the .json file is not secured, and you should not use this. You should not use the JSON to contain the sensitive information, because going to the students folder, I can easily, if the hacker or someone try to access that, he can easily access that folder. So data.json, as I created htaccess, I am going to do one thing, that I am going to cut this one and I am going to paste it here. Now students is empty. Okay, so students, then data.json, location is changed. Okay, so if you put any sensitive information somewhat, it will be visible to in front of the user. If he can just run any JSON file, if it is possible for the hacker to run the JSON file, he can easily see all the information here. So never do that. In order to put the sensitive information, always do that, create a PHP file. For example, I need to put sensitive information but in JSON format. So what you do, that create a file data.php, and then the JSON data you put using a PHP variable like this, PHP. So all JSON you will have to include into here like this. So the JSON file started from here like this, this one, and here it was like this, and then it was like this. So it was actually the JSON file, JSON data in that format. So I put that data into a JSON variable, that is a PHP variable. So if I need to pull that information later, I will just call the JSON variable, I will get that information. As this is a PHP file now, so the if a person try to access it like this data.php, actually he will not be able to see anything because I did not use any echo here. As I did not use any echo or printer, etc., this type of variable here, so an information that is just put into a variable, you will never be able to see that straight using the browser in PHP. So this is the basic thing in order to protect your folder. So keep this in your mind and apply when you will work in a project.